Now kind of glide around up toward me now, like that. Just turn as you're progressing up here. I try to tap into where they are coming from. Because a lot of these people, you know, they don't have anybody in their lives that are supportive of their careers. And so when they come in here, I just bombard them with support. So I begin to get out of them more and more of that attitude of success and confidence and achievement that they have achieved. Have no mercy on us, Debbie. I work with people from all walks of life, but they're all performers to some extent. I think we all are in life, and we're all doing our thing, doing our act out there. Wow. I work with people that are authors, like Judith Krantz, and I work with ministers from churches. I work with heads of large corporations like PSA Airlines. But there's one thing that they all have in common, they're all champions that I work with. They're all achievers, they're all winners in whatever they're doing.
That's it. Look toward me again, Debbie. Perfect.
I find it real exciting to work with people because they've had to work really hard to achieve what they've gotten. I feel like I'm a little selfish in a way because I get a little something from them. And a little something from their success. And I find it exciting to find out what made them get as good as they've gotten.
Well, Harry, I found it pretty exciting, too.
Let's talk a little bit about today's shooting. Liz is a very beautiful girl, but not yet very, very famous. Now, you've worked with her once before. Let's go back to then. When you first met her, do you see in your mind's eye the kind of pictures that you want to take, or does that just develop as the shooting goes on?
Well, I pre-plan pretty much every shooting session. I sometimes plan a week in advance, sometimes a couple of days in advance. And with Liz, I know that she had done a Playboy cover, and she had a few films that she just got through doing. So I figure that she's pretty heavy into her acting work. I'm not photographing her as a model or photographing her as an athlete. But she is involved in a lot of athletics. She does scuba diving, and she's a real daredevil girl. You know, she's very adventurous.
I don't see myself as a sex symbol because I don't really see how you can classify something as a sex symbol. I see it as it's a job and I'm fitting the job. I'm basically pretty shy. That's why I guess I could never see myself on a poster.
She's got this down to a science, friends.
Stars. I love the stars on your ears. So outrageous.
When it comes to stars, they are always out in Harry Langdon's studio. Today, he is one of Hollywood's premier photographers, with a client list that reads like a who's who among famous TV, motion picture, and recording artists. Mild-mannered yet full of flair, Harry has made his living capturing the beautiful faces of people like Cher, Joan Collins, Victoria Principal, Sophia Loren, and Dynasty celebrity Heather Locklear.
Get the rowdy attitude again. Perfect, Heather.
First of all, he's so easy to work with. And also, I'm not used to modeling or posing. I'm not very good, and I feel a little uncomfortable doing it, and he makes you, or me, feel very much at ease.
Right now, we're gonna meet a man who shoots swimsuits better than anyone else. His name is Harry Langdon.
Harry Langdon's tear sheet looks like a who's who in Hollywood. Stars and starlets glamorized by a master idealized in his photographs. His dramatic use of light and color give him tremendous commercial appeal. His photographs have often made their careers, and in turn, they've made his. Harry Langdon has probably shot more stars than any photographer in Hollywood.
There's a lot of good photographers in this country, and we all are in competition for after that one thing, and it's that high energy level. And some guys have it better than others, and hopefully that's what you're seeing in the pictures.
Langdon was shooting a layout for Muscle and Fitness magazine when we showed up to watch him work. He shoots a lot of swimsuits for advertisements, for publications, and for stars who are trying to propel their careers. The results all wear that Langdon stamp. The sets are electrifying, the lighting's dramatic, and his subjects emote an almost ambiguous sensuality, something between confidence and carnal knowledge. Langdon has shot many covers for LA Magazine over the last 10 years. His credits also include Glamour, McCall's, and Time Magazine.
One of the keys to my success, I believe, has been that I'm a good craftsman in what I do. I mean, I can take a good photograph. I like to capture a person almost off guard. It's that spontaneous glance that doesn't last very long. This lasts for thousandths of a second. I sometimes use the term we're unzipping our bodies and allowing people to see into our souls, you know, when we're being photographed. At least that's what they should be doing.
It's $3,500 a day if you want Harry Langdon to peer into your soul. And it's safe to say he comes well recommended. Expensive? Maybe. But it's hard to haggle over price when someone takes the best you've got and makes it better.
What do I think of photo sessions, Harry? With all due respect, Harry Langdon, the greatest in the business. Well, the man is partially blind, so he's not dazzled by my beauty. Isn't that true, Harry?
That's right.
I don't break the equipment. No, this is very difficult for me. And Harry, we've done this for, I think, 15 to 17 years. I think you took my elementary school pictures, didn't you, my sweet? I think it was the first job. It's very hard for an actress to do this. You know why? Because you're stopping life and you're going...
That's it. Out of sight.
If there's one time that all of us want to look and feel beautiful, it's when we're having our picture taken. Not surprising that Victoria Principal booked for a photo session with Harry Langdon, insist on bringing her hairdresser and our magazine's very own, Josiah Bear. Harry, how important is hair in a photo session?
Well, Pat, I've noticed that sometimes if we do a still session and if the makeup is perfect, photography is perfect, the clothes are perfect, but if a girl's hair is not together, if it isn't done well, it can just counteract the whole effects of all those other things that are just perfect. I become at one with the subject, I begin to feel exactly how she or he may feel while they're working in front of me. And I found that this has always been something I've always relied on, that the subject will somehow dictate or tell me how they would like to be photographed. Most people have some person inside of them they would like to show. Now, some really successful people in the business have tapped into that special person inside of them, and like an Anne Margaret, perhaps, Victoria Principal, and they have finally found this personality inside them that is extremely attractive. I have sort of a secret, which I'm divulging, that most of my pictures, I tend to direct them toward the women in the audience. It can be everything from sometimes even admiration and being able to relate to certain pictures and all that. So I direct the pictures I'll be doing today on Joan will be directed toward the women out there mostly. And if the women love them and the women find them very attractive and stunning and all those adjectives, the men also, I know, will like them.
You play music during the photo sessions, usually selected by the personality. So what will you select for Joan Rivers?
With Joan, I will probably play Fred Astaire music. Fred Astaire is pretty romantic stuff, you know, and it will arouse some memories that she's had of New York and Broadway and nightlife and romance. It's a wind-blowing now, you guys. It's really good. It looks really beautiful.
And the world is cold. I will feel a glow just thinking of you.
That's beautiful, John.
And the way...
Okay, we've got that one, John.
I'm not finished.
It had confidence. I could
set up a camera and time shot myself.
He just makes you feel glamorous. He just makes you feel wonderful, glamorous, like a movie star.
Fire!
Out.
The fire,
you're the better.
Just the way.
Do Farrah?
Mm-hmm.
She jogs past my house with a hand-drawn extension cord.